All right, let's do this. Faster compilation with the parallel front end in Nightly. Okay, so apparently maybe less parallel. We were less parallel at one point with Rust. I don't know. It looked very unparallel. You know when you used to build, it would just like literally say the numbers and go one by one through? It kind of looks like they did a topological sort and then never actually did a topological sort with groups. If you don't know what a topological sort is, you know, next Friday or next Thursday, free on Twitch, I'm going to be doing an 8-hour course that touches on topological sort. Anyways, you should know this by now, okay? The Rust compiler's front end can use parallel execution to significantly reduce compile times. To try it, run Nightly compiler with the -z threads 8 option. This feature is currently experimental, and we aim to ship it in stable compiler in 2024. Keep reading to learn why. You gotta learn why. Don't tell them to skip, Rust. Okay, don't tell them to skip this. Okay, make them learn. Make them know. Show them. Expose them. All right, compile times and parallelism. Rust compile times are a perennial concern. Really. The compiler performance working group has continually improved compiler performance for several years. For example, in the first 10 months of 2023, there were mean reductions in compile time of 13%, in peak memory use of 15%, and in binary size of 7% as measured by our performance suite. Okay, assuming that their performance suite is telling the truth, you know, I don't know how they measure, but to me, what seems to be a significantly better measurement is that they own crates.io. They know a bunch about compiling. They should have just literally used crates.io. We reduced our machine overhead by 15 machines at any one time, or 21 machines out of 400, or whatever it is, right? Like, if they just did that, you would know exactly how much are you actually improving. Because I always have a worry about performance suites, right? Performance suites, because they're not real sometimes. I just want to see the real deal. Just say how you affected crates.io, and then we can all move on, right? It would make perfect sense. However, at this point, the compiler has been heavily optimized and new improvements are hard to find. There is no low-hanging fruit remaining. But there is one piece of large but high-hanging fruit, parallelism. The current Rust compiler user benefits from two kinds of parallelism. The newly paralleled front end adds a third kind. Okay, I'm getting excited. We're getting ready. Existing inter-process parallelism. When you compile a Rust program, Cargo launches multiple Rust C processes. Yes, I've seen this because all my cores go bye-bye. Compiling multiple crates in parallel. This works well. Try compiling a large Rust program with J1 flag to disable parallelization, and it will take a lot longer than normal. So it'll take from 5 minutes to 20 minutes? Got him. All right. You can visualize the parallelism if you build Rust Cargo's timing flags, which produce a chart showing how the crates are compiled. The following images show the timeline when building RipGrep on a machine with 28 virtual cores. Okay. Let's see. We got a bunch of stuff going on right here. Fantastic. And then we hit this really long, definitely not in parallel anymore. Oh, this must be a bunch of like all the dependencies? How did Serde get way down here? How did Serde JSON get way down here? How did Serde and Serde JSON get down here? It seems like Serde should have been up here. Obviously. Duh. There are 60 horizontal lines, each one representing a distinct process. Their duration range from a fraction of a second to multiple seconds. Most of them are Rust-C and And the few orange ones are build scripts. The first 20 processes all start at the same time. This is possible because there are no dependencies between the relevant crates. But further down the graph, parallelism reduces as crate dependencies increase. Although the compiler can overlap compilation of dependent crates somewhat thanks to a feature called pipeline compilation. Oh, cool. There is much less parallel execution happening toward the end of compilation, and this is typical for large Rust programs. Interprocess parallelism is not enough to take full advantage of many cores. For more speed, we need more parallelism within more processes. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. I hope you guys are getting excited. I'm getting excited for whatever this is. Let's do this. Okay, so they do obviously do a topological sort and execute things as parallel as possible. So that, I mean, That should not be surprising. All right, existing interprocess parallelism, the backend. The compiler is split into two halves, the front end and the back end. The front end does many things, including parsing, type checking, and borrow checking. Until this week, it could not be parallel execution. Okay, interesting. Because I know borrow checking is like a huge, is definitely slow. I know linking and borrow checking are like the two big slowdowns. So if you could do like a parallel type checking across your project, could you potentially find problems before you have to do all the slower parts? I don't know. It's kind of an interesting concept what you can do in parallel, right? Type checking, all these things. Parsing. Why can't you just parse all the things in parallel? I don't know. I don't know the answers to these. I have no idea how the compiler is set up. The backend performs code generation. It generates code in chunks called code gen units, and the LLVM processes these units in parallel. This is a form of coarse-grained parallelism. Okay. Okay. We can visualize the difference between serial front end and parallel back end following the images shown shows the output of the profiler called Sampley. Measures Rust-C as it does a release build of the final crate in cargo. The image is superimposed with markers that indicate front end and back end. Okay. Front end. Back end. Okay. I feel like we can see some problems here. Right, that doesn't look good. Can we all agree that's not a W? Can we get Fs in the chat? Maybe like an F, two Fs, three Fs, five Fs? How many Fs can we get in the chat? Have I given five Fs? Okay, we got enough Fs. We got enough Fs to move on. Forget you guys. No, you shut up, okay? Don't you come in here dropping Fs. All right, each horizontal line represents a thread. The main thread is labeled Rust-C and is shown at the bottom. It is busy for most of the execution. The other 16 threads are LLVM threads called CGU0 through CGU15. There are 16 threads because 16 is the default number of codegen units for a release build. Classic. 16 for 16, you know what I mean? There are several things worth noting. Front end takes 10.2 seconds. Back end takes 6.2 seconds. The LLVM threads are running for 5.9 seconds of that. The parallel code generation is highly effective. Imagine all those LLVM executed one after another. I can imagine. I can see it. I can feel it. It's kind of like the front end. Even though there are 16 LLVM threads, at no point are all 16 executing at the same time, despite this being run on a machine with 28 cores. The peak is 14 or 15. This is because the main thread translates its internal code representation, MIR, to LLVM's code representation, LLVM IR, in serial. This takes a brief period for each code gen unit and explains the staircase shape on the left-hand side. Okay, okay. The front end is entirely serial. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so it looks like we got a lot of W's going on here. Looks like we got a lot of potential for some dubs going on here. This reminds me back in the day when Remulia conquered the Philistines and negotiated trade contracts at the same time. Thank you, history buff. I mean, I understand we have some history buffs going on here. You know, contract trade negotiation, always very difficult. You know, people have been stuck on that. I mean, we're still stuck on that, so... Congratulations, that guy. All right, hold on just one second. I want to pull up Twitch chat so I can actually read it instead of reading it off my own feed. Right now, I'm literally reading it off my own feed. And that's really annoying. I'd rather read it in a dedicated window. All right, let's pop this bad boy out. Let's pop it out. I'm somewhat of a buffery of history myself, yeah. Off your own feet, yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. All right, here we go. New intra-process parallelism, the front end. The front end is now capable of parallel execution. It uses Rayon to perform compilation tasks using fine-grained parallelism. Okay, okay. Many data structures are synchronized by mutices and read-write locks. Atomic types are used where appropriate, and many front-end operations are made parallel. In addition of parallelism was done by modifying a relatively small number of key points in the code. The vast majority of the front-end code did not need to be changed. Okay, this better be amazing what we're seeing. There we go. That looks good. This looks much, much better. I like what I'm seeing right here. This is cool. I like that whatever this Sampley is. I've never seen Sampley, but it has this nice little... what's it called? Like, how much actually is being used? Kind of cool. It's kind of weird that they all dip at the same time. You know, just interesting more than anything else. So this does obviously reduce compilation by a huge percentage. Awesome. When parallel front end is enabled and configured to use 8 threads, we get the following sample profile when compiling the same example before. Okay, faster. Front end execution takes 5.9 seconds down from 10.2. Backend takes 5.3 down from 6.2. Nice. And LLVM threads are running 4.9 seconds of that down from 5.9. Nice. The additional seven additional threads labeled Rusty operate in the front end. They reduce front end times. Time shows that they are reasonably effective, but the thread utilization is patchy within the 8 threads all having periods of inactivity. There's room for significant improvement. I like hearing this. Okay, this is actually pretty cool. So here, we'll skip that. So how to use it? We do this little bad boy. Okay, so let's get nightly. Let's actually just try this out. I like this idea. All right, so I'm gonna go like this. Cargo clean. Right, there we go, RMRF, let's just make sure, okay, target's gone, fantastic. So let's do ourselves a little bit of rust up, a tool chain install nightly, let's make sure we're on the tippity top, all right. What version do we need? Does it say what version we need? It says it's in nightly, but like, what does that mean? Is there like a 1.7 something? How do I know I have the right things? Oh, well, whatever. We'll see. We should be able to see. Do already work on resolved issue about memory leak? There are some cool tools for memory leaks and all that. Valgrind is pretty great. You also, if you're doing just like JavaScript and you're looking for memory leaks, you got yourself a little bit more of a goofy way you have to approach it, which means that you're going to need to use like Chrome DevTools and do heap snapshots. I've accepted the inevitable and swapped to NeoVim. Good job. All right, there we go. So now we're on the latest of the latest nightly, 1.75. Hopefully that is where we need to be. And so what we're going to do is I'm going to go like this. Cargo, build, release. Oh, crap. Cargo, clean, time, cargo, build, release. Let's just do a very simple test for ourselves. Very simple. Obviously, this is not real. Again, crates.io with thousands in thousands of buildings all the time would be fantastic. All right, there we go. Pretty great. We're looking pretty good. I think we're pretty happy about that little number right there. So I'm just going to copy it. I'm going to do a cargo clean. Oopsies. Cargo clean. Apparently, I cannot type today. Cargo clean. And then let's do this thing right down here. Let's go down here and let's execute this bad boy. I just want to see it. I want to feel it. You know what I mean? I want to feel that. All right, so what are we looking at? 154 seconds of time overall, but actually 18.37. Okay. We had 18.37. I think we had the same result. I mean, technically, it was slightly slower. Okay, so I don't think – I must not have this version because that should have obviously worked. Right, that should have obviously worked. Here, we'll just go to 16. You know, when in doubt, just add more threads. That's what I always say. Well, that's awkward, yeah. I know, it is a little bit awkward. Blazingly fast. Is there a way to clean all of cargo's data? Is there a way to... Yeah, okay. Somehow that did not help me. Is there a cargo reset? Yeah, that's not a real thing. RMRF root. Okay, I could try that. More threads equals slower. Yeah, I don't know if that's actually true. The problem about doing anything on your own system is like, dude, I have like Twitch running. I have YouTube videos up. We have like a lot of stuff going on. Can't you just delete cargo? Does cargo, which cargo? See, the problem is if I delete cargo, I delete more than just cargo. Find cargo. Max depth 2. What do we got in here? We got a bunch of bin directories, so we definitely don't want to do that. We have registry packages. What do we use here to delete all these things? Cargo cache removed or all. Okay, cargo cache. I don't think I have cargo cache. Do I? Oh, remove dir all. That's a lot of gigawatts. I just got a lot of memory back. Okay, there we go. So now let's try this again. We'll go back down to 8. Let's see how we do. I did have to download just then. See, that was kind of unfair. I had to do some downloading. See, the problem is we had this little download phase. See, it's not even fair. It still looks slow. Okay, I don't think we're getting anything out of this, okay? We're not getting anything out of this. We're not getting any... Obviously, I must be missing something. Okay. What libs are 7... No, the compiled Rust is huge. Okay, compiled Rust is giant. My nightly isn't new enough. Yeah. Are you on the right version? Let's find out. Cargo version. I'm on the latest nightly as of, like, I guess 2 days ago. I'm on 2 days ago, so I don't know if this is it. Anyways, okay, well, we'll drop the whole trying it out thing. All right, hey, couldn't get that to work. Apparently, whatever I was doing did not seem to actually make it work. So the name is, I am excited about Rust compiling faster because I do think that'd be a huge win, but still the linking is very, very slow. I'd love to see some improvements in that whole area. Jed.